Hi, this video tutorial is about how to make a YouTube video end screen to increase viewership. Do you want to get more engagement from your YouTube videos? More engagement means more views and subscribers. The YouTube end screen editor allows you to quickly and easily add mobile annotations to the end of your YouTube videos. For example, you can get viewers to subscribe, watch a related video, or even redirect them to your website. Here's an example of how an end screen appears at the end of your video.
Click preview. First, you can download my checklist. Then I got the suggested video. Then I've got the playlist. And finally, got my subscribe link.
Stay tuned for the steps of how to add an end screen on YouTube.
Log into YouTube channel. Click on the video manager. Select the video that you wish to add an end screen to. Let's select this first one. Click the drop down. Click end screen and annotations. Here's a pop-up that says end screen elements and annotations can't be used on the same video. I've already got annotations on this video, so I can unpublish the annotations, then create the end screen. So I'm going to select a different video. Here's a video that doesn't have an end screen. So I click the drop-down, click end screen and annotations. Now I've got a grid on top of my video. So if I click view, it says show grid, snap to element, snap to grid. So you can put any of the elements on top of the grid. If you click use template, you can select any of these templates if you want to save time. If I click import from video, it says import an end screen from one of your videos, or you can enter YouTube video URL. YouTube gives you 20 seconds to add your end screen to the end of your video. So my video is 229 seconds and it starts at 209, but you can add your end screen anywhere on this timeline within those 20 seconds. Click add element, link to an approved website, click create, and I can link to an associated website, so I can select from any of these sites that are associated with my YouTube channel. I can select the merchandise site or crowdfunding site. So I'm going to select this website. I'm going to edit the URL to add my squeeze page URL. Click next. Gives me a title here, video optimization checklist. I'm gonna edit that to say video upload checklist, and I can select a call to action. Learn more, visit, sign up, shop, download, order, buy. I'm gonna select download. Here's the image that's taken off my squeeze page. I can also change the image and upload a different image from my computer. Click create element. Here's the element to my squeeze page, and I can move this around anywhere on this grid. Put it on top left here. And at the top it says, at least one element must be a video or playlist. So you must add a video to your end screen for it to work. So click add element. So I'm gonna add a video. Click create, and you can add the most recent upload, best for viewer, or you can choose a video or playlist. I select best for viewer because YouTube's gonna show the best video based upon the viewer's past viewing experience. Click create element. Up the top here it says please add space between the elements, so I gotta move this down. And now I've used 2 out of 4 elements. Now I'm gonna add a playlist. Click add element, click video or playlist, click create. It says choose video or playlist, so I'm gonna click playlists, video optimization, click create element, and I'm gonna move this one to the bottom right. I can also expand this if I wish to. So now I have 3 out of 4 elements, and the last one I'm going to add a subscribe button. Click add element. So with subscribe, promote subscriptions to your channel, click create, and I'll move this one to the top right. Now I have 4 elements on my end screen. I can move these on the timeline to appear at any time during the last 20 seconds. I'm going to move the squeeze page at 209. I'm going to move the best for viewer video 3 seconds later to 212. I'm going to move the playlist to 15. I'm going to move the subscribe element at 221. And then I can shorten the 20 seconds by just moving these, say 225. And up here it says, please add space between the elements. Move this one down a bit. I click preview. First, you can download my checklist. And I got the suggested video. And I've got the playlist. And finally, got my subscribe link. I'm going to click save. And that's it.
Here are five important things to keep in mind.
Number one, make sure all your end screen elements are relevant to your video. Number two, annotations and end screen elements can't be used on the same video. So if you select a video that's already got annotations, you have to unpublish it, add the end screen, and republish it. Number three, encourage viewers to click the call to action elements inside your end screen. Number four, make sure you leave 20 seconds at the end of your video to add your end screen elements. Number five, create your end screen elements so they appear at different times on your timeline.
That's it. Now you know how to add a YouTube video end screen and increase viewership. If you want to receive more video tutorials like this one every week, please subscribe to my channel and check out the other videos in my playlists. Click this image to download my video upload checklist. You'll learn the 10 things that you need to do before going live with your video on YouTube.